Hello again. Last time we discussed what the fundamental property of reality is, and we concluded that its existence, meant as a property. Today we will discuss how this property behaves, and what roles does it have within reality itself. Now, what do I mean by role? A role is an identity. For example, a house serves the purpose of welcoming a family, as well as providing a job for the builders. That is two purposes that a house fulfills, which means it has two roles, family welcomer and job provider. Everything has a purpose, and something doesn't have to be an entity in order to have a role. Because properties also serve a purpose. So, what are the roles of existence? Well, since without existence nothing would be, then existence must be the cause of everything. It must be the cause of time as well, so existence is also eternal, because it's not existence that relies on time, but it's time that relies on existence. Same goes for space, making existence omnipresent. Existence also is the basis for every action. And therefore everything possible subsists thanks to existence, which thus can be called omnipotent. The same applies to knowledge. All knowledge exists because of existence, so existence is also omniscient.
But Thomas, an entity has properties, how can a property have anything like that?
You see, if knowledge, time, space, or anything didn't come from existence, they would have come from something else. But there is nothing else, and they can't have come from nothing, so the only explanation is they came from existence itself.
But that doesn't make any sense. I don't understand it.
I know you don't understand how, but there is no other logical alternative, so just because you don't understand something, it doesn't mean it's not true.
But the paradox of omnipotence. Nothing can be omnipotent.
The paradox of omnipotence makes no sense. If you know what omnipotence is the ability to do anything logically possible. And since nothing illogical is possible, the paradox of omnipotence is merely a contradiction that leaves you nowhere.
But
it's like saying, this statement is false, it's a paradox but this doesn't mean the statement doesn't exist.
But
now we will treat a very complicated matter. So pay as much attention as you can. Remember this thing from the first episode? I made this as to make it obvious that without existence, represented as the color green, there would be no substance, the area inside the shape. However, if I drew it this way, that would still have been the same concept, but it would have been a different substance. This means that the way existence behaves determines what an entity is. We call the shape form. So a square and a circle are both shapes, and are both delimited by a line, but the shape of the line makes them different. Likewise, a duck and a pizza are both entities, and both subsist thanks to existence, but the form makes them different. This explains how there can be different entities, while there being only one essence. A good analogy is the guitar analogy. Just as one string of a guitar produces many different sounds based on how tense it is, likewise existence can produce different entities based on how it's arranged. Lastly, existence is also the end of everything, its goal. What I mean by that is existence also shapes the direction and the purpose of all entities. Why? Simply because existence is the cause of that direction, and the final point also must be existence. Because again, if it wasn't existence, it would be something else, but there is nothing else. And therefore this scenario must be false.
But Thomas, everything is just matter arranged in different shapes. The universe is meaningless, it has no purpose.
Here's where you're wrong. It's easier to understand this if you picture entities as vectors, A vector needs three things to exist: a starting point, a modulus, and a direction. If one of those is missing, the vector itself stops existing, and that includes the direction as well. This can only mean that everything that exists also has a purpose, otherwise it wouldn't have a cause, and thus wouldn't exist. Rocks exist, therefore they have a cause, therefore they also have a purpose. So far, we've pointed out three roles for existence: cause, form, and end. About those three, we must say that they're not the same thing, despite them all being existence.
But Thomas, how can existence be both cause, form, and end while those three aren't each other?
The same way a house is both a shelter and a job provider, despite the fact that shelter and job provider are different things.
That's modalism. Those three parts of existence are just different ways it manifests. They're not actually existence itself.
Not so, because those three are the fundamental units of existence. Without one of them, existence wouldn't make sense, and thus those three are not contingent things, but the only non-contingent thing that exists is existence itself. Because we saw in the first episode that existence cannot be denied, and those three also cannot be denied, while everything else can. Therefore, existence is those three things, and they aren't just different aspects of it. Existence also has one essence, because otherwise there would be different kinds of existence, which is impossible. Therefore, cause, form, and end are all existence, while still not being each other. Let's clarify something. Everything is caused by the cause. So the form and the end both come from the cause, and also, the end comes from the cause, and from the form. Because different shapes are made for different purposes, and therefore a different shape determines a different end. So there you have it. This is the most accurate representation of the property of existence. That's all for today. Next time we'll dive further in those three roles of existence, breaking them down until we find out how sensible objects are made. See you next time. Be well.